Hello, I'm Heather Koenig, and this is WKTV News. On May 2nd, the City of Wyoming's residents will be asked to open its library millage to help with the park improvements. With more on that, here's WKTV's Joanne Bailey-Borsma.
Now that much of the necessary updates have been completed for the Wyoming Library, Wyoming city officials are turning their attention to the parks. Having identified more than $23 million in park needs, the city is asking voters on May 2nd to open up its library millage to help fund with park improvements.
So here we're at the point now where we're saying, okay, we don't need to make significant investment in library maintenance for the next 10 years. So we have a choice. Can we ask the voters to recognize the maintenance and capital needs in the park system? And would they allow us the flexibility to use some of those library maintenance funds now on park capital?
The millage proposal would not be an increase to residents, but would shift about 0.16 of the mill levy, which would be used to pay off a $4.4 million bond for park improvements.
Well, from a mill levy standpoint, it is less than $12 a year that will go. So it's the cost for the average homeowner in the city of Wyoming, less than one cup of coffee a month.
Four parks have been designated to receive the funding because of growth in the area or needs caused by the flood and two tornadoes, all of which have happened in the last 4 years.
Learn more about the millage at whyparks.com, so that's a quick link area. They can go to the City of Wyoming's initial website, wyomingmi.gov, look up Parks and Recreation, and they'll have the master plan that's right there as well.
If approved, the millage will be for about 15 years. Design work and possible construction could start as early as 2018. And this has been Joanne Bailey-Borsma with WKTV News.
The City of Wyoming will be hosting informational sessions to educate voters and answer questions. Those sessions are April 24th at 7 p.m. at the Gazan Fire Station and April 29th at 10 a.m. at the KDL Wyoming branch. Also, there are two openings on Wyoming's Park and Recreation Commission. For more information, visit the city's website at wyomingmi.gov. Frederick Meyer Gardens and Sculpture Park recently announced it will be expanding and upgrading its facilities starting this year, and a big part of the work will be associated with its Youth and Community Learning Center, already a favorite part of local after-school youth programs. WKTV's Ken Norris brings us the story.
The multi-phase building expansion plans of Meyer Gardens, announced last week, include a new 60,000-square-foot welcome center, a new sculpture garden entry plaza, upgrades to the concert amphitheater and picnic areas, and expanded parking. It will also include an expansion of the institution's learning center, which is already a destination for several Wyoming and Kentwood youth organizations, including Kentwood Public Schools' ARC after-school program. Following recent educational additions to other Grand Rapids area institutions, including the Gerald R. Ford Presidential Museum, Meyer Gardens' new Covenant Learning Center will, quote, engage learners in new ways and reinforce our commitment as the go-to place for cultural education. That, according to supplied information from Meyer Gardens. The new 20,000-square-foot Covenant Learning Center, which will include new and expanded classrooms with access to natural areas, will be topped by the also new Podnos Families Rooftop Sculpture Garden.
The expansion plans are a result of a nearly complete $115 million capital campaign titled Welcoming the World, Honoring a Legacy of Love. The campaign currently has raised about $102 million of its goals. Construction is scheduled to begin this fall and continue for approximately 4 years. For more information, visit meyergardens.org. Recently, area residents came together to honor the memory and contributions of civil rights activist Cesar Chavez. For more on this year's Cesar Chavez Social Justice March and community gathering, here is WKTV's Bree Wilson.
The Cesar Chavez Social Justice March took place right outside of Cook Library and ended at Powder's House Church. This was a time for the community to unite while walking the streets of Grand Rapids arm in arm.
What I hope to gain from being here at the march is just to see everybody united and just to kind of think back to everything that Cesar Chavez means to us, and just so that everybody can see that unity of everyone coming together for one person and everything that he's done.
And for me, it's to show all the young folks that haven't known about our struggles that we've had, that this is what it's all about, the unity. Now at this time that we have all these problems going on with immigration and everything else, show the unity. Show people that we care for each other, and that's what it should be.
After the march, there was a community gathering, and President Juan Olivares of Aquinas College and President Stephen Ender of Grand Rapids Community College were honored by the committee to honor Cesar Chavez for their outstanding hard work and dedication throughout the years. This is Bree Wilson with WKTV News.
This is Heather Koenig for WKTV News, reminding you to stay connected to your community by visiting now.wktv.org.